What's going on, guys? Exactly 5 years ago today, as I'm recording this video, I started my very first sales job. Between my junior and senior years of college, I was a business development intern at an equipment financing company just outside of Philadelphia. And I remember the first day I was super nervous. I didn't know what to expect. I walked in, I was greeted by the president and founder of the company, who was my boss. He introduced me to everyone at the company, and then he brought me over to the youngest sales rep that was working on his team, sat me down next to him, and told the young sales rep, get Matt on the phones. No coaching, no training, no role playing, trial by fire. I remember as I went to grab the phone to pick it up to make my first ever cold call in my entire life, my hand was shaking, my heart was beating, my face was red, I was uncomfortable, and I was wishing I was doing anything else other than picking up that phone to call someone. I have no idea who they are, they have no idea who I am. And I was wishing and hoping, as the phone is ringing, that it's going to go to voicemail, because I have no idea what I'm going to say, and I'm pretty sure the person on the other end of the phone is going to hang up on me. Thank God that first cold call went to voicemail. My wishes were answered. I didn't have an opportunity to have a conversation, embarrass myself, and get hung up on. And I remember I was going to hang up the phone, and the younger sales rep said, Matt, keep that phone to your ear. We're going to keep dialing numbers until you have a live conversation. That is how I got my start in sales and in cold calling. That summer, I made 100 cold calls a day, got hung up on all the time, got berated all the time, didn't know anything, didn't know what I was doing. That's how I got my start. I woke up every single morning anxious and nervous to make my cold calls. I had extreme anxiety when it came to cold calling. Extreme anxiety. I hated it, right? And in this video today, I wanted to share with you guys how I've been able to best manage my anxiety so you guys can best handle yours and have some fun while you're cold calling so you can close more deals and make President's Club. To start, whenever I picked up the phone to make a cold call, I viewed my anxiety and nervousness as a negative. And I remember a while back, I mentioned to one of my mentors that I viewed it this way, and he changed my mindset completely to view this as a positive. My mentor and I, huge sports fans, we connected on sports, and he sent me this clip.
I'm never scared to do things on the basketball court. Sure, I'm nervous because of the challenges, maybe the events that's happening around the game itself. But once I'm out there in the motion of playing, I have total confidence in my basketball skills, and that's going to get me to be comfortable once the game starts. But once the game started, I am not nervous. Before the game, I could be nervous. I'm pretty much nervous at every game. But once the ball goes up for the jump ball, I think all that nervousness just kind of goes away, and I revert back to things that I've practiced, things that seem to be very routine, and I'm very comfortable in that environment.
The GOAT even got nervous before every single one of his basketball games. My coach said to me, Matt, you need to start viewing your nervous energy and anxiety towards cold calling as a positive. You're nervous and you have anxiety because you deeply care about what you're about to do. You care because what you do might be of service and might help that company either now or down the road. So that's number one, you deeply care. Now, number two, when you have nervous energy or anxiety to do something, your adrenaline starts to race, your heart starts to beat, your focus increases, and you have tunnel vision on what you're about to do. You're 100% focused on that cold call. So we're no longer going to view nervous energy or anxiety around cold calling as a negative. We're going to view it positively because it means, number one, you care deeply about what you're about to do, which is potentially helping that person on the other end of the phone out. And number two, you're 100% focused and tunnel vision on making that happen and making that cold call. Amazing advice. And I know that some of you guys who view it negatively, this will help you out greatly, and start viewing it positively because it is a positive. Also, Michael Jordan, he didn't become the GOAT and just stopped being nervous before all of his games. He got nervous before every single game that he played. And he was the best of all time. You can become the best cold caller you could be. You can master the art of cold calling. And you're still going to get nervous and anxious to pick up that phone and make a cold call. I get nervous and anxious. I made tens of thousands of cold calls in the past couple years. And I've invested a lot of time and energy and gotten pretty good at it. And I still get nervous. I embrace it. I don't fight it. I don't try to fix it because it's a waste of time. Embrace the nervousness and push through. For cold calling, you better be role-playing every single day before you pick up the phone and make your first cold call. You got to role-play how to open the call, how to handle the gatekeeper, the questions you might want to ask, how to handle all the objections, how to close out the call, your tonality and pacing. all of that, if you could role play all of that and you could get into the flow of having conversations before you pick up the phone, you're going to be well prepared. There is no substitute for practice, even when you master the art of cold calling. Salespeople are goal-driven people. We want President's Club. We want to make six figures. We want an exotic car. If I don't hustle and pick up that phone and make a cold call, what am I telling myself? I'm communicating to myself that I'm not worthy of my goals. I'm weak. Cold calling can help me achieve my goals, and my goals should always outweigh my fears. Whatever's holding me back, I push through and execute. And if not, if my fears outweigh my goals, I'm in the wrong profession. As a salesperson, when you start viewing your anxiety and nervous energy around cold calling as a positive, because it means you deeply care about what you're about to do, you have tunnel vision on making that cold call, you're well prepared because you role played every single day before you pick up the phone to make your first cold call, and you have complete 100% focus on your goals, you're going to be able to push through and get really, really good at cold calling. Guys, I'm really passionate about fear, nervousness, mindset, all of that around how to become a better salesperson, business professional, and personal development. Let me know in the comment section below if you want me to make a part two on how to get over the fear of cold calling, because there's techniques and strategies that I didn't talk about in this video that have helped me out. And I'd be more than happy to go in depth on a second video. So let us know in the comment section below. Like and subscribe. And look out for videos every Tuesday, Thursday, and Cinema Saturday. Thanks for watching, guys.